the sky. You had one long horn, one big eye. I missed a shaking and I said, hooey. It looks like a purple people eater to me. It was a one-eyed, one-horned, flying purple people eater.
One-eyed, one-horned, flying purple people eater.
A one-eyed, one-horned, flying purple people eater sure looks strange to me.
One-eyed?
Well, he came down to earth and he lived in the tree. I said, Mr. Purple People Eater, don't eat me. I heard him say in a voice so rough,
I wouldn't eat you cause you're so tough.
It was the one-eyed, one-horned, flying purple.
Virtual summer reading programs. This week, if you couldn't guess, is all about supernatural creatures. So we have aliens and ghosts and monsters and all that fun stuff to talk about today. So, Miss Kimberly's out of breath. We are going to start with a story. We're going to do a ghost story today, and then we will show you the activities for this week. And if you would like to do a take and make, we'll give you the information at the end so you'll know how to pick up your craft materials. All right, deep breath. Okay, so because we're doing a ghost story today, I am not gonna start with, what's popped up? Thank you. I had in my mind that I wasn't using it, so I couldn't remember it. So we're gonna start with long, long ago, okay? So. Long, long ago, when the West was still wild, there was a little town that had a little inn that people from all over would come and stay at when they were traveling from place to place. And at the top of the inn, there were rooms for people to stay, and at the bottom, there was a tavern, and that's where they would serve dinner. Now, most of the time, it was very quiet in this tavern, but every once in a while, they would get a rough and tumble cowboy who'd get all ornery and he'd start a ruckus. So one day they had a cowboy come in and he was a poking and a jabbing at everybody, and finally they got tired of it and somebody walked up to him and punched him right in the eye. He got a great big black eye. Well, he started punching back and pretty soon they had a brawl. Now it got pretty ugly. And our cowboy fell and he hit his head. And the tavern keeper said, "This has to stop. Take him up to room 2 and call the doctor." But the doctor wasn't fast enough and our ornery cowboy died. But before he died, he said, "I will haunt this room forever." And from that point on, every time somebody would take the room, that ornery cowboy with that big black eye would show up. So one day, a school teacher came in, and she was traveling to her new school, and she said, "I need a room to sleep." And the tavern keeper said, "All I have is room 2, and it has a ghost." She goes, "I deal with ornery school children all day long. No ghost is gonna bother me." So she goes upstairs, and she goes into the bathroom, and she brushes her teeth. Pachoo! She pulls out her brush, and starts combing her hair. Pretty soon she hears, shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. She turns around, there's nothing there. So she's brushing her hair and she hears, shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. And then there's a cold wind across her neck and she turns around and she is nose to nose with the ghost. And the ghost says, "I'm the ghost with one black eye." And she goes, flying behind her. Now, a few weeks later, a cowboy comes in and he says, "I'm tired of sleeping on the ground. I need a bed." And the innkeeper said, "I'm sorry. The only room I have is number 2 and it has a ghost." And he says, "I wrangle the meanest steers all day long. I'm not afraid of a ghost." He goes, "All right." So the cowboy goes up and he looks. He doesn't see a ghost anywhere, so he goes in the bathroom and he brushes his teeth. No ghost. So he goes and he sits on the bed and he goes to take off one boot, drops it on the floor, and he hears shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. And then a cold breeze goes past his nose And he looks up, and he's nose to nose with the ghost. And the ghost says, I'm the ghost with one black eye. And that cowboy hollered real loud, snatched up his other boot, jumped on the bed, climbed out the window, and started shinnying down. Ooh, there goes my hat. Started shinnying down the drain pipe. And he's whistling for his horse, and the horse rides up, and he lands on his back, and off they go. Now, a few weeks later, the sheriff shows up, and he says, I need a bed. Tavern keeper says, sorry, all I've got is room 2, and it's haunted. The sheriff says, I wrangle the worst, orneriest outlaws in the state. I can handle a ghost. Keeper says, okay. Gives him the key. The sheriff goes in the bathroom, flushes the teeth. Pachoo! Goes into the bed, pulls off his boots, takes off his badge. Still no ghost. So he climbs into bed and he opens his book and he's reading and he dozes off and he hears shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. And then he feels a cold breeze right across his ear. And he looks up and he's nose to nose with a ghost. I'm the ghost with one black eye. Well, that sheriff wasn't as brave as he thought he was, because he jumped up and he grabbed his boots and he grabbed his badge and out the door he went, saying, I'll never stay in that room again. Now, some time goes by, and there's family who comes in, and the dad says, I need 2 rooms, one for me and my wife, and one for my son. And the innkeeper says, I don't know, I've got 2 rooms, but one of the rooms is haunted. I think you better keep your boy in your room. The boy goes, every day I wrangle with the worst schoolyard bullies. I can handle a ghost. And the keeper shrugs, says, okay. Boy goes in, brushes his teeth. Pachoo! Gets out to the bedroom, takes off his boots, puts on his pajamas, climbs into bed. And he's laying there, just starting to drift off when he hears shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. He feels a cool breeze go across his head, but he just lays there. He hears it again, shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. Cold breeze blushes right across his nose, but he still doesn't move. And then he hears it again, shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. Right in his ear he hears, I'm the ghost with one black eye. And the boy sits up, both of his fists ready, and he goes, oh yeah? Well, if you don't hush up and let me get some sleep, you're gonna be the ghost with 2 black eyes. And the ghost was so surprised, but then he said, I'm gonna get this boy. And he came after him, and the boy doubled up, and he punched him in the eye, and poof! There went the ghost. And never ever did that ghost come back and haunt that room. So it was our little boy who was the bravest of all. And that's the story of the ghost with 1 black eye. All right, we are going to go on to our activities for the day. We are going to start with Miss Suzanne.
Hi, everybody. Okay, so today, because our theme is supernatural, we're going to make a handprint alien. Now, grown-ups at home, just so you know, this paint can be a little messy, so you might want to help or at least make sure your area is covered. So what we're going to start with is the things that are in your take and make. You have all your paper, 3 different papers. The spaceship and the bubble for the spaceship both have a template, so it's easy for you to cut out. Some things you will need from home are glue and scissors, a white or light colored marker or pencil or crayon even, and there's paint in your take and make as well. It's just a little container of paint. So to start, the first thing we need to do is to make our handprint, because it needs a little bit of time to dry before we glue it on our black paper. And Miss Kimberly is going to come over and help me, and she's going to make her handprint for me. All right, so in your container there's some green paint. You can either press your hand into the paint on a paper plate or something flat, but you want to get the whole hand covered. Then you're going to want to press it right into the center of the circle. Just push it down. Now I'm going to hold the paper so when she lifts up her hand, the paper doesn't come with it. So it looks like this. Thank you, Miss Kimberly. She's going to go wash her hands now, which is what you need to do after you do your hand. Your handprint looks like this. I'm going to take some of the paint and just kind of fill it in a little bit so it looks a little bit more full. So you should end up with, this is your alien's body and eyes. So I'm going to set this over here to dry, because this morning I made my own handprint, so that way it would be all ready to dry by the time we got to see you guys today. So you're going to take your handprint after he's dry and glue it onto your black paper. You kind of get to decide where you want to put it. I'm going to put this one kind of over to the side here. Okay, I'm going to set that aside. Next, you're going to want to cut out your spaceship. This is your spaceship. And then you're going to want to cut out of the yellow paper some lights. Now this one has yellow circles, and then for this one I did triangles. So here's some triangles. I'm going to glue on the other two. Now, I'm going to draw like a line across here so it kind of makes a mark where the lights go, just to give it a little bit more. Pizzazz, so to speak. Okay, so now you're going to put your spaceship onto your alien bubble. You're going to put some glue on the back of this guy. You're going to kind of want to decide where you want it to go. Just like that. And then the last thing to do, actually there's two things I have to do. I'm going to put some eyes on my alien. So in your pack you also have this little strip of stickers. I'm just going to put a sticker for each eye. And then I'm going to use a marker and just draw some eyeballs. Okay, so there's that. So now my alien has eyes on his head. So the last thing you can do, if you want, is on this one I did stars. So this one I might do some stars. But I think I'm also going to do maybe a moon. So there you go. Now you have a handprint alien. All right, thanks guys. Now we're over to Miss Rosalie.
Hey everybody. So today's snack is going to be a monster. So in your snack bag, you have a Rice Krispie treat, either orange or green frosting, and some candy eyes. Okay. So you'll want to open your frosting and open your Rice Krispie treat. And now this is your alien's body, and you want to give your alien like a little head. So we'll use some frosting, spread around on the top. And then you can decide if you want one, two, or three eyes. So I'm gonna give my monster three eyes. And there he is. Fun, tasty monster. Oh my gosh, he's kind of scary. I better eat him fast. Okay, have fun.
All right, everyone. Now we are going to make alien slime or monster slime, however you want to look at it. So I'm going to pull up my monster sleeves here so I don't get them in here. So what will come in your kit is a bottle of glitter glue. This little bottle here has saline in it, and we'll get to that. And this little container has baking soda. What you'll need to provide is about a half a cup of water, You want some kind of a bowl. It's nice if it has nice tall sides like this, so that you don't get too messy. And then you're gonna want a measuring spoon because you're gonna want about a tablespoon. Oh, the other thing in your pack are eyeballs, and we'll tell you when to add those. So the first thing you're gonna do is put your glue into the bowl. I like to take the top off because then I can get the glue out faster. And you're gonna wanna try to get all that glue out. Now, obviously you are not going to get it all because it's hard to get all of the glue out. And even when I think I got it all out, I turn it the other way and I still end up with some in the bottom of the container. But that's okay because there is enough in here to make your slime and have a little bit extra as well. Now, I like to use glitter glue because if you know Miss Kimberly at all, you know that she does not like free-floating glitter, but it's captured in the glue, so we can do that. So put your glue in there, add your water. You're gonna add your baking soda. Now, I learned that the baking soda is what gives it its stiffness. So if you want slime that's not quite as stiff, mine's a couple of weeks old, so it's a little stiffer, but you can put a little less. If you want it a little more stiff, you can put a little more, but that's about a teaspoon. And then the magic solution is the saline, but you have to be careful because if you do too much, it actually will start making it so it's not slimy anymore. So it takes the sticky away, but it can also break down the slime. So I like to start with a tablespoon, and your little container should have about 2 tablespoons in there. So you can start with 1 and then use the little bit extra to help get the sticky off at the end if you still need to. Okay, so I'm gonna hold it up a little bit so you can kind of see there's a fair bit of liquid in there. So we gotta get our hands in there. Now Miss Kimberly doesn't like sticky hands either, but she can do slime because it eventually stops being sticky. But so you gotta kind of mix it up, and especially with the glitter and the glue, it wants to kind of stick to the bottom. But to really make it get going, you gotta really knead it. So you gotta make your hands go like this, okay? Now, for the grown-ups, sometimes you have a little one that loves to get sticky hands and to touch this kind of stuff. And so if that's the type of child you have, then let them go for it. You're probably gonna have to get in there a little bit and help them so that they get all that liquid mixed in there. But sometimes you have a little one that really doesn't want to touch it. And that's okay too, but that means that you're gonna end up doing all the hard work here. So you can see, hold it up in just a second, it's almost there. I've got most of the liquid in there, but it's still pretty sticky. So I'm gonna keep really pulling at it and kneading it just like you would knead dough for bread. It's making some great noises over here. I don't know if you guys can hear them. But the more you work with it, it starts to become a little more solid and stretchy, and it's sticking to my hands a little bit less. Now this is where you have to kind of test to see where you're at with it, because my hands still have the saline on them. So I'm gonna make Miss Corinne, who is behind the camera today, come over and just grab a handful and see if it sticks to you. So see, it's sticking just a little bit to her. Little bit. See, that's why we like to test it. So what I'm gonna have Miss Corinne do is take our little bit of saline, just put a little bit in there for me. Oops. Just add a little bit more in there. Oh, I forgot, we need to add eyes. We better do that before we get too mixed up in here. You can really add the eyes at any point as soon as it starts to get slimy. If you add them too early, it just adds to the chaos of trying to get it mixed. But then as you kind of finish that mixing, you see how the eyes kind of all bubble up in there. And then what's really fun is if you put it in a bag and you stick it on your boss's desk, your dad's desk, or somebody's desk, and you leave it overnight,
They come in and there is a glob with eyeballs staring at them on their desk. So it's kind of fun. So, but you can see now we're to the point that my hands are pretty much clean and the slime is totally malleable. So you can play with it. It's gonna be like this for a couple of days as long as you keep it in a plastic bag. Like I said, my first set here is about 2 weeks old and it still got some stretch into it, but it also tears. So it's not gonna last forever. So if you're gonna play with it, make sure you're playing with it in those first couple of days. All right, excuse me. All right, I think that is everything that we have for you today. So let me very quickly give you the take and make information. Oh, and also tomorrow we have Jiggle Jam has done a pre-recorded children's music video, so we will release that at 1 o'clock. And then on Thursday, back here at 1 o'clock, we are gonna do an indoor camp out, so that's gonna be a lot of fun. And if you would like that Thursday take and make packet as well, you can schedule that when you pick up your Tuesday. So you'll get a packet like this. In order to pick it up, we need you to call the hotline, which is 720-425-9319. I'll put that into the description as well. And schedule a pickup. We do them Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday from 2 to 6 p.m. So just give us a call. We'll schedule you for a time. When you get here, park on the garage side. Call that number again. I'll give it to you again at the end. And we'll bring it out to you, and then you can have fun at home. And that number again is 720-425-9319. And that's all we've got for you today, but we are gonna take it out with just a little more of the Purple People Eater.